In this video you are going to find out how to set up and commission KUKA SeamTech with WorkVisual. First you have to connect all the cables and set up the hardware. Start with the power supply. Continue with the data connection cable to the camera. Plug in the Fieldbus connection to the robot controller. Plug in the other side into the robot controller, port XF5, and the Fieldbus connection to the programmer laptop. Lastly, plug in the data connection into the camera on the robot. Now that the hardware is set up and ready, install and open WorkVisual on your PC or laptop. First, open your WorkVisual. In order to install and configure tech packages, you need to install the options in WorkVisual. Choose in the WorkVisual Project Explorer browse. There you find your connected robot controller. It is important that you activate the option Download Necessary Options. With that option, all necessary option packages will automatically be downloaded from the controller. Open the project tree and choose the active project. Now the project from the controller will be opened. The required options will be also downloaded, and the dynamic option package profile is created and activated. After the download, WorkVisual will automatically restart. After the restart, WorkVisual opens the project again. In the next step, you are able to start with the SeamTech configuration. First, you have to add a sensor to your project. On the right side of your screen, you will find the catalogs. There is a tab with the options. These are the downloaded options from the beginning. Pay attention, for all the options have the same version on the PC as on the robot controller. Open the option SeamTech with pressing the plus button. Now choose the ST sensor, and add this sensor via drag and drop to your project. Now you are well prepared for configuring your SeamTech sensor. Open the previously added sensor via double click. The SeamTech editor will be opened. In this example, it is shown a commissioning of an ServoRobot Powercam. KUKA offers for a lot of SeamTech sensors pre-configurations. If your sensor which you want to use is not shown in the drop-down, then you have to choose a custom sensor. Through this selection you choose the standard communication protocol. For your specific sensor you can write your own if needed. After choosing the correct sensor you have to configure the IP address, communication ports, as well as the distance between scan lines and activation delay. At the end you can decide if you want to use this kind of sensor for SeamTech finding and or SeamTech tracking. Now the WorkVisual configuration for SeamTech is done and you can deploy your project to the controller. The WorkVisual configuration is done, but there still is no communication to the sensor. Next step will be to configure the network communication between SeamTech sensor and robot controller. Navigate to the network configuration and open it. Open the advanced settings. There you have to add a new virtual interface. Give the new interface a meaningful name. Choose for the address type, mixed IP address. In the next field IP address, you have to write in an IP address located in the same IP range as the sensor IP address. The subnet mask has to fit to the IP address. Press the save button and restart the controller. After restarting the controller, you should check the communication. For doing this, you should try to switch on the sensor via soft keys. If the sensor is switching on, the communication is ready and you can go on with the calibration. SeamTech offers two ways to calibrate the tool: the automatic calibration and the manual calibration. In this video, both calibrations will be shown. For the automatic calibration, you need a calibration body. This can be made on your own. How this calibration body should look like is described in the SeamTech documentation. If your calibration body has different dimensions, you can change it in the SeamTech sensor calibration editor. For the manual calibration, you can use the same calibration body, but you can also calibrate directly on the part or somewhere else. A base calibration is not needed for the manual calibration. Before the automatic calibration of the sensor can be done, you have to calibrate a new base on the calibration body. Navigate on your smart pad to the tool Base Management. Add a new base. Choose a meaningful name and calibrate the base on your calibration body like shown. Save that calibration. Open the robot menu, Configuration SeamTech Calibration. In the SeamTech sensor calibration, you see all your configured sensors. Do the sensor calibration for each sensor if you have more than one. Press Calibrate to switch to the sensor calibration. First, you have to write in the correct calibration task. That is the number of the detection task, which is configured in the sensor software for detecting the feature on the calibration plate. Second, you choose the correct reference tool. That is the tool which is used for your application programs. Third is the sensor tool. There you can select a tool number which is still not used. This will be used afterwards for the tool data of the sensor. Fourth is to choose the calibration base. That is the base which was calibrated on the sensor calibration body before. Fifth is to select if you want to do the automatic calibration or the manual calibration. Now you are doing the automatic calibration. Now you can start to teach the two positions. If you press on the position you want to teach, you will see a picture how to teach that position. Move the robot to the position shown in the picture on the smart pad. After reaching the start position, press touch up. Move the robot to the second position. Press touch up. Now you can start the calibration. Press start calibration. If the message sensor calibration successfully executed is shown, the calibration is finished. Now you can close the editor and answer the question if you want to save the changes with yes. Now the manual calibration. Navigate to the SeamTech sensor calibration editor. Press calibrate on the sensor you want to calibrate. Do the configuration of the calibration task, reference tool, sensor tool and calibration base like at the automatic calibration. For the selection of a calibration base, it is not necessary to use a pre-calibrated base. You can use a base number that is not used yet. SeamTech will use it internally for the calibration. Now it is important that you do not select automatic calibration. With the manual calibration, you have to teach 5 points instead of 2 points for the automatic calibration. If you press on the position you want to teach, you will see a picture how to teach the position. Teach the start position first. This one is above the calibration body. Second position is the feature POS. There you have to move with your application tool TCP to a defined position. Third is the MIS POS 1. For teaching this position, you have to switch on the laser of the sensor. Now move with the laser line of the sensor to the position of the application TCP before. Pay attention to a good recognition of the sensor during this and the next two positions. Fourth is the MIS POS 2. Move the robot a little bit higher and be careful that the laser line is still in the same position as before. Fifth is the MIS POS 3. Now move a little sideways and again keep the laser line on the same position as before. Now all positions are correctly taught, and you can start the calibration. If the message sensor calibration successfully executed is shown, the calibration is finished. Now you can close the editor and save changes if wanted. For further questions on the topic, please contact the KUKA customer support or search for information on KUKA Expert.
Industrial intelligence.